Good day, students. Before we begin with our discussion, my sincere prayers for us and our family's health and safety in these trying times. This is Session 3, Introduction to Research. Today, we are going to discuss the following topics: definition of research, characteristics and its types, importance of research, and a glimpse of research ethics. At the end of this discussion, it aims you to have familiarity and understanding of research in general, its characteristics, appreciate its importance, and be aware of some ethical research processes. Let us begin by defining what research is. Research is a systematic process of inquiry that includes data collection, analysis, and interpretation. It follows a valid methodologies across different academic fields or disciplines. Let us focus on these keywords. Research is said to be systematic because it follows a certain process. Generally, it starts from problem or topic, then objective setting, gathering of related studies and literature, data gathering, analysis and interpretation, generalization, and conclusion, as well as its recommendation at the end of the chapter. Research is said to be valid, meaning it should show facts, truth, and have evidences. Considerably, it follows accepted and valid methodologies. Remember, research varies from one discipline to another, such as in soft sciences and in hard sciences. Soft sciences such as economics, business, management, psychology, philosophy, and hard sciences such as engineering, biology, botany, and other related fields. Moving forward, we should understand the different characteristics of research. Research is said to be empirical if it is based upon the real-life situation or phenomena and undergone systematic understanding and or analysis. It is analytical in the sense that it uses evidences, figures, references, and producing statements or observation. Considerably logical, for it complies with rightful thinking through sound judgments from observation, phenomena, or study. Research is inquiry-based, for it starts with query or questions or series of underlying curiosity. Research is also dynamic, such as behavioral researches that changes and adapts to the variability of its surroundings. It is also methodical, for it follows a systematic process and can be replicated for continuous research activities. Moving forward with understanding of types of researches, we are going to classify research into two. Take note that as references varies, typologies also changes. For the sake of leveling of knowledge, we are adopting these two types. The first is types of research according to purpose. There are three categories under this type, which is basic research, applied research, and evaluative research. Basic research is also known as traditional researches. It aims to understand the status quo or describe the status quo. Applied researches, on the other hand, are specialized researches which calls for an action, platforms, framework, or series of actions in aid of policy. Evaluative researches uses evaluative tools in assessing certain situations or phenomena in order to adjust, adopt, and be used as a framework in the future. The next type is according to data. Mainly, there are three typologies under this. These are qualitative research, quantitative research, and mixed research. Qualitative research mainly uses descriptive skills. Also, it uses verbals, symbols, and also picturesque of the whole research design itself. The unique characteristics of quantitative research is it uses numbers, statistics, and mathematical designs in understanding its research phenomena. Mixed, on the other hand, is a combination of qualitative and quantitative. Also, mixed researches is also called triangulated research. Specifically, there are six basic researches under qualitative. These are phenomenology, case study, ethnography, grounded theory, historical analysis, content and discourse. Phenomenology talks about the lived experiences of the understudy. Case study focuses on a specific place, a specific subject at a specific time. Ethnography, on the other hand, focuses on the beliefs, traditions, cultures of certain ethnic groups. Grounded theory focuses on proving or disproving theories and existing theories to be used. The last two types of qualitative designs will be levied to you as your activity assignments in our Google Classroom. Moving forward with quantitative data, descriptive, inferential, and experimental designs are under this category. Descriptive simply describes the research under study, such as demographic profile, socioeconomic profile, as well as economic profile. It also encompasses the mean, average analysis, and the basic statistical tools. Inferential, on the other hand, is uniquely focused on hypothesis testing, whether they reject or accept. Some of here are correlational, regressional, and causal approaches. And the last one is experimental, which can be controlled or semi-controlled. Some references mention other types of researches under quantitative, such as exploratory and the like. Now, why do we research? Basically, we research because we seek for innovation and continuous learning and aid in the improvement of knowledge and understanding of our world, thus giving us a mobilization as a catalyst of change, leading us for a facts-based decision and control decision. Especially in business, we decide based on the figures and understanding of consumers or producers or any stakeholders in the market or industry, thus giving us the opportunity to improve our quality of life, preservation of culture and environment, of course, including social, economic, and scientific growth. Here are some views of research ethics. Research should comply with data credibility, with full honesty on the type of data that we are using. Also, protection and preservation of life. This is one of the pressing issues, especially in life sciences. Ownership. This doesn't pertain to the originality of work, but rather the ownership of the research. Today, it includes the patents, copyrights, or intellectual property schemes aimed to protect the ownership of an individual with regard to research. Integrity. We must remember that in research, we are the reflection of our work. On how honest we are in conducting research is considered as one of the main factors in research ethics. Impartiality. We should conduct research without bias because we follow the scientific method of process. I'll be sending some materials for you to read and to ponder on with regards to research ethics as updated in 2020 and is being used nationally and internationally. If you have questions, kindly use our Google Classrooms for interactions or question interactions and turned in. With this is your teacher, Sir Jericho. Thank you and mabuhay!